You've known him for his crazy stunts, witty comedy, surprise after surprise. This time, Erica Mondi comes to you untamed. This is Erica Mondi's Naked Truth. He has something they're all looking for. Erick Omondi Untamed, Carnival Grounds, 22nd of March 2014, 6 to 10 p.m. Brought to you by Safaricom, MoSound, OLX, AdSight, and Vintage Events. One man, one mic, one stage.
Put your hands together for Erick Omondi.
How are you? Thank you very much for coming out. Give yourselves a round of applause. Asante sana. Asante. And today, better still, let's do it the Nairobi County way. If you're a man from Nairobi County, lift both your hands up like this and clap once. And if you're a lady from Nairobi County, shika hapa, na useme, thank you very much for coming out. The ladies look lovely as usual, looking better than the men, yeah? I see even Dottie. Hey, Yawa. You are here. Seated at the VIP. Dottie at Dottie. You know, there are different kinds of people who come to events. There are those people who sit at the VIP. They are called the very important. And then there are those people who sit at the IP. They are called important. Alafu kuna wale wanakuanga wale huko nje wanaitwa P. Wanaitwa nini? They are just
people.
They are just
people.
But ladies, you're looking amazing. Could you give yourselves a round of applause for outdoing the men? You know, I love, by the way, Dottie, you are seeing my friend Dottie. She's from Nyanza. When you see a woman from Nyanza, ameketi chini, unaweza kumdharau, you might not even notice her. Yeah? You might not even see her. In fact, when you pass, she's the one who will be trying to get your attention. Sasa wewe. Sasa wewe. You will pass again, she will try again. Wewe sasa. You will not notice her. But wait until she stands up. When you come back, she will tell you. Ukirude, kumbra. Sasa. Utajibu. But no, when ladies are seated down, you cannot tell much. When ladies are seated down, you can never tell much when they're seated down. Because last week I was in a club and I saw a beautiful, beautiful lady. She was flawless hair, you know, the skin smooth, lovely eyes, beautiful smile. I had to gather courage to go and talk to her. So I went to her with courage. Kufika hivi, she stood up and she saw me. I will not say which part of the country she comes from, but her legs. Zile kwa zinakaa kama zangu. Immediately, my focus came from her face to her.
Yes.
I could not help because I saw something familiar. I couldn't help but look at her legs. And she was trying to hide her legs. Ladies, you cannot hide your legs behind your legs. I will see one of them. And she was there busy telling me, Eriko, washa kuangalia miguu. Urebo ni shura. Tazama farao, usistaajabu ya Musa. But no, ladies, you're amazing. Ladies always outdo men. They dress. Have you seen the way ladies arrive at an event? Like I saw some ladies coming in, especially from Islando. Hallelujah. And this is what they believe. They believe if you come early, you get the best seat. Oh my gosh, trendy haraka mapema ndio tupate VIP. You do not get the VIP because you came early. You get the VIP because you bought a VIP ticket. Ndio? Ati wana sasa wewe unaoganga aje tumekosa VIP. You have to pay for it, yeah? Ladies, give yourselves a round of applause for that. We appreciate it. You know, and do you know how ladies get into a quasi arrival? Ladies, when they get into a club, especially a club, they usually look different from the way they leave the club. When they get the club, they're composed, all beautiful, the composure, like, oh my gosh, and even the English. He's very smart and intelligent. Yeah. Yeah. Sweets, let's do brackets. Then Scarlett's my guy, duh. Some guy's trying to check me out. The English is smart and intelligent. And even the way they dance. Even the way they dance when they get to the club, very composed. Very nice. But I don't know what happens. Sazile Pombe in a check-in. When alcohol checks in, the first thing that goes is the English. They start fighting with everyone, including the waiters. Wait, but they are out at we beer. No, out at we beer. Sit down, mekunywa. Mekunywa short status. Ndio, mimi mefanya tequila ngapi? Sita. Wewe mekunywa smile of saba. Ndio, 650 metoka. You know, let me tell you one thing. These ladies, when they are dancing, when they come in, they're very composed. I mean, Muguzi ko pamoja. Muguzi ko pamoja. Mugu, I don't know what happens. When alcohol checks in. Say asante sana usiende kwa mpesa dadangu tafadhali tusimiane eh namwambia asiende kwa mpesa juu so waboy yeye ndo kwa namwambia hivyo. But you know they say that that man evolved, they say that man evolved from a homopithecus position, yeah, all the way slowly to homo habilis, yeah, and then finally to homo erectus. But ladies evolve the other way around. When they get to the club, DJ, they get the club in a homo erectus position. Homo erectus. Homo erectus. Anakunywa kidogo, homo habilis. Pole tu, homo habilis. Homo habilis. Homo pithecus. Homo pithecus. Homo pithecus. What an evolution! You know, men never go homo habilis. All men do in a club is this: homo erectus, homo erectus, homo erectus. And you know, Nairobian men are so uncultured, yeah? Your woman is homo habilising. Your lady is homo habilising. And this is all they do. That is all they do. Your woman is busy homo habilising and your homo erectaing. And then they even have the audacity to receive a phone call when your woman is homo habilising. Kuja second floor. Nakuona. T-shirt ya green. T-shirt ya green. Kuja. Manziangu. Ako hapa. You cannot do that. That's why I appreciate men from Mombasa. Wapi wakofi out of Adali. Gentlemen. People, watu wakona utu, wakona bogda, wakona mautui na riwaya. Wakona, wakubala na mimi, amina. Hamka wevi basi. Wakubali. Mombasa tunao. You know, Mombasa men also dance with their ladies bend over, yeah? But they are gentlemen. They communicate with the ladies. You know, Nairobian men only communicate with the DJ. Utadunga yo, akingia. Ndona kam, amefika, tunga. No! Don't talk to the DJ, talk to your... Yeah, watu Mombasa, huko na ngoma ya Mombasa. Waki dance. mwanangu. Amina. Wansokota mbilingo mbilingo. Kiuna sio. Sio mwanangu. Mio sweaty. Mwanangu. Anataka sasa wa dance bend over. But you have to be wise. They are wise about how you ask your lady. You have to be very, very. Wisdom has to play. So wanakuja. Hey, Amina. Asema hamisi. Mwanangu pole pole hamna haraka. Ani naswali Amina. Naswali mwanangu. Uliza. Aswali yenyewe ni kama medali. Ilhali ni swali. Uliza wewe. Alikuwa anauliza. Mtaka cha mfunguni. Very nice, superb. You have to be very, very smart, yeah? But let me tell you one thing that Nairobians have not learned. Now they talk about clubbing. Nairobians have never learned when to club and when not to club. This is a good time to club after February, after. There are 2 months that Nairobi County needs to understand. December and January. Very different months, but very related. In December, by the way, try calling a Nairobian in December, hautamsikia. Because in December, all Nairobi, hautamsikia, mpige simu. Mpige jemo. Akishika tu hivi. Hello? Hello? Uko wapi? Unafanya nini kwa nyumba wewe? Toka kwa ni Disemba bwana. Hai, uko wapi? Tuko Mombasa, tuko Mombasa bwana. Tuma text, tuma text. Tuko Mombasa. Oh, uko Nairobi. Chukua taxi, chukua taxi. Chukua taxi, si ndio? Chukua taxi kutoka Nairobi uende Mombasa. Si ndio? Wachana na yeye. Usisumbuana na mtu wa Nairobi in December. Give him time. Don't call him in December after that. Call him in January. Atashika simu na utamsikia clear. Ni saa sita mchana, but ni kama ni usiku wa manane. Hello? Sema niaje. Jemo. Sema nakusikia. Wewe buda uko poa? Niko fiti mazi. Uko wapi? Wapi tena, niko kwa hao. Buda, unafanya nini kwa hao saa sita? Buda, unajua, leo ni Monday. Nimetoka church. Tulianza fasting leo. Tunamaliza Friday mazi. Nakakesha. Buda, lakini uko kwa hao, sikuja tuwe lunch. Mazi, sasa utafanyaje? Utafanyaje, so uende Malindi. But let me tell you one thing. I have decided this 2014 that I'm going to be more than a gentleman. I'm going to treat my woman, my lady, my girlfriend, or my wife with respect and in the right way. What makofi yangu? Asante sana. I've decided that. In fact, even I will take her out. I will take her for movies. I will even take her to church. Yes. Hallelujah. So that it's complete, yeah? And this year I've decided that I want positive energy. I want optimistic people to be around me. And even when I take my woman to church, you know that some churches you go to, you don't have anything, yeah? You don't have rent, or you don't have food. But when you go to the church, the music that you meet encourages you. Yeah? Kuna churches wanalanga, ukifika ile ngoma nasikia, tuende. We know it. Anakuliza. Are you a winner?
I am a winner.
Are you a winner?
I am a winner.
Are you a winner?
Are you a winner?
Are you a winner?
Are you a winner?
Are you a winner? Ukitoka church na feel, yeye ama winner. Utalipa rent lakini I am a winner. Hauna credit lakini I am a. You feel like a winner. Even the worship, when they play the worship, it is still encouraging. The pastor stands up and they play worship.
This is number one.
count your blessings. Name them one by one. Brother Chris, you are a drover. Name it. Even though you've taken on a loan, name it one by one. Count your blessings, name them. Cindy, very nice. You know there are churches you go to, God has blessed you with a Range Rover, you have an investment, and you're building. But when you get to the church, the music that you meet is very discouraging. Unaingia hivi na ile ngoma unasikia kwanza ni utawasha mali yako na utaenda. Ambia jirani yako utawasha. Ambia jirani yako utawasha. Mwambie utawasha. Mwambie utawasha. Dada, hiyo milioni moja ambayo kwa endelea kucheza na ucheze polepole, hiyo milioni umeshinda, umefanikisha na Safaricom, utayacha. Dada Rebeka, hiyo nyumba yako unajenga hapo Lavito, utaiwasha. Ambia jirani yako washa. Ambia jirani yako washa. Utawasha. Alafu wacha waingie sasa worship. Wakiingia worship, more discouragement.
Ulikuja bila kitu, bila kitu. Ulikuja bila kitu.
Ulikuja bila kitu. Shade, ulikuja uchi. Utarudi uchi. Utarudi uchi. Asante sana. Rabu, as though it's not enough, as though you're thinking sasa wamekuacha, utapumzika. Oh, now it's... When the pastor stands up to preach, he repeats as if to add salt to an injury. The same song they were singing. Kwaya wameimba. Wakasema. Utawasha mali yako. Utawasha mali yako. Mbembe huko, utawasha. Sio mimi nimesema. Ni kwaya wamesema. Na sio kwaya imesema. Ni wimbo imesema. Na sio wipo ile hali ni Mungu ndiye amesema. Alafu Bwana anakuambia, ah, kwa sababu ya muda hatutaendelea. Tupate kukuja next week. Ile ni wapi? Kwa nini? Watawasha. Well, you know, where I come from, we used to go to church at 9. I don't know what happened to church. We used to go to church at 9. Then around 10, at latest 11, you leave church. Then you go for family outing. So Sunday was church and family outing. Nowadays, Sunday is just church. Sunday is just... So I did a small research to find out what really happened. What went wrong? Or what went right? I discovered that the problem with the church today, it starts at 9, it ends at 3:30. And the number one reason why is because of something called repetition. I bet you're not called repetition. Unnecessary repetition. Kanisa, kila mtu wako na uchuda. Umeketi hapa uko na uchuda, mimi niko na uchuda, yeye ako na uchuda, kila mtu aseme ile kitu Mungu anamfanyia. Ndachukua mtu yote. Ndugu yangu. Kuja. Unaitwa nani?
John Otieno.
Huyu ndugu nimemuuliza unaitwa nani, akasema anaitwa John Otieno. Uko na shida gani?
Shida gani?
Huyu ndugu nilipomuuliza, ndugu unaitwa nani, akasema anaitwa John Otieno. Nikamuuliza tena, shida yako ni nini? Akasema ni yeye, umesikia? Ndugu, hii shida umekuwa na wakati gani?
Tangu last year.
Nilipomuuliza huyu ndugu unaitwa nani, aliniambia anaitwa John Otieno. Nikamuuliza shida yako ni nini, akaniambia shida ya rent. Nilipomuuliza ni wakati gani, akasema mwaka uliopita. Sitaki kujirudia. Dada, huyu ndugu amesema nini? Amesema nini?
Anaitwa John.
Nimeuliza huyu dada, huyu ndugu anaitwa nani? Huyu dada akaniambia huyu ndugu anaitwa John. Dada, amesema shida yake ni nini? Nilipo liza udana. Chena ya huyu ndugu. Akasema, nikamuliza naitwa nani? Ukasema naitwa nani? Nilipo kuliza, je, shida yake ulisema nini?
Ni arent.
Kutoka nini?
Mwaka
uliopita. Nilipo liza udana, huyu ndugu anaitwa nani? Huyu dada alisema, huyu ndugu anaitwa jo. Na, ndugu, huyu ndugu anaitwa nani? Repetition, that's why we stay in church longer. Repetition. But where I come from, you cannot sleep in church. Because pastor does not only preach, he also quarrels you. Thoroughly. And pastors have decided, from where I come from, they will not preach alone. Give me that microphone. They will not preach alone. It is the responsibility of the whole church to preach. And then the pastor is the preacher come translator. The pastor gives you a task and does not give you the chance to do it. And you have to preach together. Kawono what is so mamuma? Kuwoke dot marangwen kochi mauchia. Leo tunaenda kusoma Biblia kutoka mlango ya tatu ikielekea ya tisa. Soma Biblia.
Eka Yesu.
Eka Yesu. Soma Biblia.
Yesu
ndo watunango. Soma Biblia.
Yesu
ndo watunango.
Ndo watunango. No.
Go to the next verse. Next verse.
Yesu. No chako. Wechema.
And then he there asks you, church, are we together? We cannot be together because he didn't read anything. But you know, also where I come from, we love titles. We love to give ourselves names and titles. Even in prayer, when you are praying, we give God titles. When you are praying. Kanisa, tupate kufunga macho, tupate kuomba. Yesu baba yangu. Yesu Ebenezer yangu. Hey, Yesu seneta. Yesu gavana ya maisha yangu. Yesu party leader. Yesu engineer ya moyo yangu. Yesu daktari ya nyumba yangu. Aya. Yesu ndio Oscar yangu. And by the way, do not correct the pastor from where I come from. Don't ever try or even think about it. Don't correct. Leave the pastor alone. Don't, whatever mistake he does, never correct the pastor. The pastor can say anything. He is the pastor. Don't correct the pastor. He can come and say anything. Alafu siku hiyo, Jeremiah, akapanda juu ya mlima, akaona burning bush. Wewe unajua ni Jeremiah akupanda mlima. Lakini wachana na pa. Ujui kitu Mungu alimwambia, pengine Jeremiah alikuwa na mo. Usikorek. Kwanza usiku ukijaribu ati, pastor, burning bush ilikuwa ni Moses. Brother Joseph, unanikosoa na hujakosoa nyumba yako. Ungalijua nyumba yako vile unajua Musa. Atunge kuwa tunavutana. Church, let's close our eyes and pray for Brother Joseph. Utaombewa. But I've decided, ladies and gentlemen, that 2014 is going to be the year that I'll be more than a gentleman. I will treat my lady right, and I will be the smart guy who treats my lady. Yes, I will do everything. I will take up the best hotels. And then, gentlemen, let me help you understand. You can tell the difference between an expensive hotel to take your lady and a cheap hotel not to take your lady. Number one, this is for men. The music that comes out of that restaurant will tell you whether it's cheap or expensive. Cheap or expensive. If the volume of the music is low and the music is soft, that is an expensive, classy hotel, like Serena. Very, as the people from Akinadoti say, very serene. Because, you know, the reason the music in expensive or restaurants is very low and very soft is because the things they're saying can be heard anyway. They're not embarrassing. Yeah? The conversation needs to be heard. There's nothing happening that is embarrassing. Yeah? Hello? Yes. Nico Intercontinental. No. The senator is here. Governor is on the way. Bob, ametoka kidogo. To a signed contract, 3.5 million. Okay, you get here. Very nice. The conversation is not embarrassing. People can hear it. And listen to the music. Ambience. Tell them ambience. You are paying for the ambience. You are paying for what? Not the food, the ambience. That lady is right here. But I never think I'm go wrong guy. So that people can talk. Yes. No. They swipe. Very, very nice statements. Ukienda hoteli, where the music is louder than you. And the reason they're doing that is because vitu nasema are very embarrassing. Very. Unaenda hoteli, ngoma ile inacheza. The reason the music is very loud is because they're trying to cover you. The things you're saying are very embarrassing. Should the power go out anytime in the middle of a conversation? Vitu mtasikia stima ikipotea. Ikipotea. Ha! Ayayayayayaya. Abia mtu wa mayai anifujie ine. Mtu mayai nilete ine. Abia tayo. Kunyo kwa bili yangu. Patie kege. Abia mtu wa pikipiki ya zilwake. Mtu wa pikipiki ya goje kidogo. With that noise, there's still someone on the microphone. All that noise, they didn't get you to make more noise. Kuna band na kuna mtu anakuchezea?
Ikimamba sana wapi nduru wewe?
You tell me what will happen in the morning. But you can tell whether your neighbor went to an expensive classy hotel or a cheap one in the morning. Just the way they're talking, yeah? People went to Serena in a serene place. They have everything intact. Their voice is intact. They look fresh. Their energy is there. Yes. Yeah. It's okay. I will forward it on email. Yes. Hey. No, we left Serena quite late. No, very late. Honey, what time did you Serena? 5:30, yeah. 5:30. Yes, we left at 5:30. Yes. Okay. No, let's do Sankara. Let's do Sankara today. He still has the energy to do Sankara. Let's do Sankara today. Maybe Serena tomorrow. Ukienda hizo zile za nakwambia, you need 4 days to resuscitate. You need a lot of water. Alafu, huyo neighbor kipigwa simu. Your wife has to wake you up. Now, finally, we should go kishika simu. Jemo, seven years. Who the copper? Seven years. Who the copper? 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 Jana liko wapi tukuta mipuda, puda, chana wacha tukushuu, tukutuka Skylax, sema makarau, sema alkoblo, puda mazi puda, lakini kulipapa aje, kulipapa aje. Aso jemo mazi ni aje, uwezi kwenda out jano, situende leo, wacha uchinga, wacha uchinga. Auna. You own a voice. And man, the first thing is music. The second thing that will tell you whether the hotel is expensive, classy, or cheap, yes, is when you enter a hotel, the signages, the notices you see, will tell you instantly. Yeah? Once you get to an expensive hotel, before you even pay for the hotel, they give you a tap, a hot, they give you drink, juice. See there? You have not even paid for the hotel. You might not pay, but you shall go to the juice. Now you are what to happen when another to Sankara will put the juice. And I was suited at 7. Do you have rooms? They are put the juice. But the signages you see, they are telltales. Yeah? When you enter a restaurant and the first thing you see is notice slippery floor. Slippery? Slippery floor. You walk. Mind your steps. Mind your steps. They care about you. Mind your steps. Una tell you see wet paint. Do not touch. If you see wet paint on the wall of an hotel, that's a very expensive hotel because they think about renovating. They actually paint the hotel. They paint it maybe yearly. So next time you see wet paint, respect that hotel. And when you go to sleep, when they take you to your room, they give you history. Tell them about history. The room we have just given you, that exact one. Bill Clinton was in that room with Hillary. And we have even never changed the bed sheets. That one. Very nice. They give you history. But you go to a hotel, it has never been painted. It is written, established 1463. You enter, and you know, Kwanza, you come in, and the signages you see, they also give you history. Unajua hoteli? Hakuna hoteli kama hii. Hii ni hoteli iko na history. Unaweza Kenyatta? Washa nikwambia, Vasco da Gama mwenyewe alala pale. Hiyo dirisha unaona imepasuka. Ilikuwa ni Mau Mau. Hiyo ilikuwa ni mshale ilikia ikatuga veteran at the history. Now the signages you see when you come in, the signages you see are very scary. They are not even notices. You come in, it's not written notice. You come in and you see warning. Useguze transformer iko tatro. Kuna transformer tatro. Uko bezume na usha woniwa. What is a transformer doing on that floor, seriously? Transformer never need that floor. But ladies and gentlemen, I've decided that 2014 is that year when I do my best. I will treat my lady right. I will be more than a gentleman. Yes, thank you. Who is that who said, yeah, right? Give me my phone. Don't say, yeah, right here, and I can unajua simu yangu inaweza tuma pesa bila kuchukua namba ya mtu. Ukipiga tu picha yake unaweza mtumia mpesa. You have to swipe the mpesa. You have to swipe the mpesa. I saw size 8 somewhere. I hope my coffee is size 8. Tafadhali. Size 8 or that shit. Apo hapi size 8. Aliona pale, unajua size 8 alikuanga ile program ya tujuane. Size yako ile inaitwa tuone. Well, I hope my coffee is celebrity couple DJ Mo and size 8. Very nice, very nice. But hey, Jalama alituambia, she's no longer called size 8. Anaitwa Fungu la Nane. Fungu la Nane. So from today we call her?
Fungu la Nane.
Fungu la Nane, chapter 8. Chapter 8. Size 8, asante sana makofi yake. The best DJ, DJ Mo, the best DJ in Eastern Central Africa. Mimi nimeenda mpaka Rwanda. Siwana DJ kama wewe, mimi nafanya kwa. Ile masaji unapatianga size 8. But you know, size 8, I really appreciate Kenyan artists. You guys have made us proud. You've taken over Eastern Central Africa. And you guys have done good. What makofi ya Kenyan musicians. But niko na shida moja. Moja tu na Kenyan artists. When you do your own song, you give it your all. You give it the best lyrics, the best tune, I don't know what you call it, rhythm, because it's your song. But when you collab with someone, you just touch. Like, a good example is you, says it. Tafadhali wacha ni kuja hapa kwa size 8. Size 8, please simama unipige mateke. You know, when you do your songs, you give it your all. Mateke, mateke. And how do you do that in high heels? Hawa ndo wale waliwaambia wakiingia wanakuanga pretty. Cheki DJ kwevu, shikilia hiyo nini. Size 8, size 8 nakikia kwa nini kwa concert. Hi guys! Hi guys! Wapi Nduru ya Yesu! Wapi Nduru ya Yesu! Okay, all right. She looks very Dure Yesu. Sidio? Dure Yesu. Watch and go my work way. Okay. Wachana kujifanya. Be yourself. You're confusing us. Hi guys. Oh my gosh. I'm so happy to be here. No. When you come in, be yourselves. Niani wase. Wase wa isani munipati. Isani munipati. Be true to you. But you guys, when you do your own songs like Mateke, you give it your all. But when you do a collaboration, the other person with the collaboration, Giuliani. Juliani when he does his own song. Uko na kumwambia Juliani.
Niko njaga siyezi karanga uwe hai shagala bagala. Niko tayari kulipa gharama. Sita simama maovu ya kitawala. Sita simama maovu ya kitawala. Ufisadi ubinafsi ukabila kuuza sura wataki.
Juliani is true to him. Says it, fanya hivyo. Wasaya, wasaya. But Juliani, when he did this song, he did it alone. He said, Nikonja hata siwezi. Then he said, Ohe shangala magala. Nikonja kulipa
tarama.
Sita sima maovu ya. Very beautiful. What makofi ya Juliani? He actually sang, he did rap. Oh, also rapped. But when Juliani did a collab with Daddy Owen. What makofi ya Daddy Owen? Kuda, kuda, ulienjoiwa. Ulienjoiwa Buddha. Listen, the moment you use the word featuring, Daddy Owen featuring, inamaanisha kuna feature. Don't say featuring. He won't give his best. In the US, they don't say brick featuring Liz. They say brick and they say, they don't say Jay-Z featuring Kanye West. They say Jay-Z and Kanye West. And. But hey, what people are going to do? Dugu. Wait, you don't want to do it. Daddy, what's my coffee? I'm going to do it. Daddy, come, come, come. Stem ya
kalungala.
What are you going to do?
Papa yeah. Solo.
Uluya itakuwa. Yano ansalamia. Buddha, wapu makofi ya Daddy Owen tafadhali kwanza. Iyo ngoma, ulienjoiwa. Nataka kukuprovia. You gave it your best. Kwanza chorus. Masikia ngoma. Utamu wa maisha, ni hati ya ujui kesho iko. Utamu wa maisha, ni hati ya ujui. Aya, nataka kukusho. Asali band, when Juliani alikuenjoy. Ulikuwa umemficha kwa hiyo video, ako hapa nyuma. Compare what Juliani is doing here, and what he did at Shagalaba. Chop your chorus, Buddha.
Sure.
Utamu wa maisha, ni hadi haujui kesho iko vipi nani.
Wambie!
Utamu wa maisha! Utamu wa, utamu wa, utamu wa.
Ati mini!
Utamu wa maisha!
Ulienjoiwa Buddha. Ulichezewa Buddha. Wapa kumpia Daddy Owen. Buddha ulienjoiwa sana. Tugu. Daddy ulienjoy wa Buddha. Ulienjoy yako wote. But Daddy Owen, nyuma yako kuna mtu amekaa hapo. Amevaa nini? Arsenal. Walichapo wangapi? Sita. Haki wait ampatie drink sita. Super Sita. By the way, he's a Manchester United fan. What makofi of Manchester. And so just to tell Daddy Owen from what happened today to Arsenal, I want to tell you that Manchester, Manchester United fan, we are in bad times and in health. Nikama Arusi by the Kukopan or Manu Azimu Seme, in good times and? Yes. So as I take a cup of water, this is to Daddy Owen, just to tell you, I know a believer that there's still hope. Sasa, sasa, your dreams, sir?
Huh?
Your dreams, sir? Huh? Yes, and those people who are seated at VIP, like Dotty, VIP, IP. It does not matter where you are seated, your presence is for?
Mchezo safari, vikombe ziko changamoto, tulishinda gathamani. Pili tumetoka mbali, kwa matatizo changamoto, kuvishwa vishwa makanzu. Otatu kidonda chetu kwenu mradi, hata kushinda kwetu kwenu ni party. Tatu kidonda chetu kwenu mradi, hata kushinda kwetu kwenu ni party. Na mudomo munapiga, tumezoea. Uivu na fitina, ai, punguza kidogo. Mavikombe kadhalika, najua munaelewa. Hapo hapo zimefika, tukiongeza kidogo. Zinaweza kumwagika. My sweetie, sweetie,
number one.
Man you,
we are number one.
My jazzy,
number one.
Roho yangu mama,
we are number one.
My sweetie, sweetie,
number one.
Manu,
we are number one.
Nina uchungu sikatai, mana uchungu akushindwa na ujua. So msije kutulagai. Nina uchungu sikatai, mana uchungu akushindwa na ujua. So msije kutulagai. Najua mogoba. I'll show you how we score goals. Goals, goals.
God has really been good to me by day. Wapi makofi ya zile vitu Mungu amenifanyia. God has really been good to me. And I just want to share with us, si kama huyo bando anazuia, in pictures, how far I've come from. Nilikuja Nairobi the first time 2003. So I just want to share, haya, can you believe that's me? Nilikuwa nimeona. No, but on a serious note, it's not a WhatsApp photo or a Facebook internet world. That was me at the age of 9. I wish my... No, 9 months. Next. That was me. Nimeanza kutembea. True story. Nimeanza kutembea. Next. Kisumu boys. Mimi ni ule niko nyuma. Alafu. Next. Usiweke picha za US. Usiweke za America tafadhali. Tuende zile za at Photoshop. That was in California. Please, let's go back to the photos nikiwa mtoto tafadhali. Buda, umefungua folder gani? Ile folder limeandika jani. This, sasa, now, sasa umefanya wasichana wote wanajua venye nakaa. Buda, ena kwa folder imeandikwa, kuna folder hapo imeandikwa, Eric Omondi's journey. Wacha na hiyo. Alafu uklik hiyo, SMS, wacha urembo wa banda. We, my dear, rudi hapo, rudi vili, tembea. Go, just, now, come. touch it. Folda imeandikwa iliko Mondi's journey, tafadhali tuendelee. Zima stima. Ai! Usiweke picha za familia. No family photos. Weka ile ingine, sio family photo. What? That, okay, sawa, usha mess. That is my former schoolmate, my colleague and future wife. Eh, okay, maliza zote basi. Eh, maliza zote za familia. Hapo ilikuwa ni 2 weeks ago tukiwa Oscars. Yes, ndio hiyo. Baadaye unajua zimeisha. Ndio hiyo, nimemnyang'anya pale Oscar. Kuna celebrate. Kuna nyingine? Ndio hiyo, tunafanya ile ya Ellen DeGeneres inaitwa selfie. Aya, ndio hiyo.
Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Tukisoma Kondele hadi darasa la nane, ukaenda Ulaya kusoma kule Meiko. Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Nakumbuka tukiwa watoto tukicheza kalongo, mimi baba na wewe ni mama tukipika mchanga. Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Lupita nyama yoyo, ubali nikuoe. Lupita nyama toti, nataka nikuoe. Msichana mrembo, baby mwenye umbo wa Kikenya, rudi nyumbani mimi nakusubiri na Oscar.
Amaranda was asked the other day that what happened this year, you guys did not, were nowhere in the top 10 or top 20. And then the head boy said, listen, and listen carefully. This year, we decided together to focus on one thing and one thing only, Oscars. So, Maranda will be back next year, before I finish, when I played some photos here, some of you thought, maybe because of the one that I'm built, you thought immediately Photoshop. That's what came to your head, yeah? But the truth is, this is a dream come true, and it took us so much to do this, to keep it under wraps. And I want to say thank you to Bwana Anyang Nyong'o, wherever you are. On a serious note, by the way, he's okay, thank you, sir. This, we had to pull strings to make sure that it is very, very, that we do it here at the Comedian Tent. It was not easy when we heard that she was coming into town with a South African camera crew. They were doing a story back in our home. They were doing a story in our home ground. And so I went to KICC and I told
I requested Anyang Nyong'o to please allow us to have her here. This is the first time, ladies and gentlemen, that she's coming to be with us. Hey! Wapinduru ya! The one and only, the award-winning Lupita Nyong'o! Ah! Hey! Take your photos. She's going to say something very short because she has to go back to her hotel room. She's going back to her hotel room. They are continuing with her shoots. So she'll say something very short, my dear, if you may, if you will. Just something, kidogo.
Good evening. Oh my God, you all look so beautiful tonight. This is amazing. So I just came over to say thank you so much for your support. It's been a long distance getting here, but as they say, you're never far from home. So I love you all. Thank you. God bless you. Have a good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Asandeni Sana, thank you for coming out tonight, but I have to take baby girl to her room. Thank you very much, Mubarikiwe Sana. God bless you. Asandeni Sana. God bless you. Asandeni Sana. Thank you guys for coming out. Asandeni Sana. God bless you. Akwaheri. Mubarikiwe Sana. Wacha nipeleke msichana nyumbani. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Mubarikiwe. Some of them are higher private investigators. Bye bye. Ah, to talk at the what at the end of Lupita? What do you want?
Nimependa show. Imekuwa something that I didn't expect. Na I think ni kitu poa medu sana. Mimi ni number one fan wa Eric. Na yenyewe pesa yangu yenyewe imekuwa compensated for.
The show was lovely. I've laughed mpaka I cried. Yeah, he's just the best comedian in Kenya. There's no one who can match up to him.
Show imekuwa juu sana. Eric anajua kuperform as in hiyo comedy amefanya yani ni kitu worth. Kama watu wanaweza kuja wajaze as in hall hivyo kubwa watu wamejaa juu ya comedy, yenyewe ni kitu serious. Na kwanza my best part kuleta Lupita, it was so good.
Okay, Eric Omondi's show was very awesome. I loved it. Everything was perfect. I just laughed till I was tired. I couldn't do it anymore.
Eric Omondi's show was good. And he talked all over. It was touching the church, it was touching the homes, it was touching all the social setup.
It was an awesome show. Actually, it's my first time to attend a comedy show and I've loved it all. The whole point was nice. I laughed a lot and it was so fun. Very fun indeed. I loved it.
How are you, Nairobi? How are you, Eastern Central Africa? How are you, Africa? How are you, the universe? This was Eric Omondi, Untamed Nairobi Edition. We had a lovely, lovely show. Thank you for your support, Nairobi. And now, this was the Nairobi Edition. Tunatoka, tunaenda California, tunaenda Seattle, tunaenda huko Houston, tunaenda ile ngine inaitwa aje, hata nimesahau hizo zote. Then we go to London, of course, and then to South Africa for the Eric Omondi Untamed World Tour. Thank you very much, Mbarikiwe Sana, for your support. It was a lovely, lovely show. Ndio watu wanaenda, hata mimi naenda kulala, nitaenda nao alafu nipumzike ndio tutoke.